Hello, Public Works and Transportation Committee members. Michael Wolf, Public Works Director. This item is the proposed speed hump program. Staff's recommendation is that the committee review and provide comments on the program, and if desired, recommend that the proposed program be presented to the City Council. So why should we consider a speed hump program? Speed humps are actually one of many traffic calming tools that we would like to use. And when we talk about traffic calming, we mean trying to reduce the average speed on street segments. And speeding and or cut through traffic is actually a really good result for installing speed humps. And we do get a significant amount of requests, as you can see, over 200 in the last 5 years. So having a program would help us address that. Also, a program would be a well-defined engineering approach to implement those requests if vetted out to enable a speed hump to be installed, and also to establish priorities. As you can imagine, we won't be able to install all of them if requested. So as previously mentioned, speed humps should only be considered after all the other options have been reviewed and or implemented. And what can speed humps do? As previously said, can reduce speeding in residential neighborhoods and actually can modify undesired cut-through traffic patterns in that same neighborhood. What speed humps shouldn't be used for, what they can't do, they should not be placed on high-volume streets, so that's our arterials and collector streets. They should be used in actually a set of three. A single speed hump actually, through research, doesn't actually help in the situation. So speed humps are typically installed in groups of three to be effective. And they should not be installed on streets where we have known drainage and flooding issues. Here's some examples, some photos of speed humps. On the left, A and C are traditional speed humps in a residential neighborhood with signage. On the right, B and D, those are also speed humps, but they're actually a specifically designed speed hump called speed cushion. As you can see in photo D, in the middle of the street there, you can imagine a wide axle vehicle like a fire truck being able to straddle the vertical components of that and not have to slow down as much. And we'll talk about emergency response in a minute. So some of the pros of a speed hump and a speed hump program is reducing vehicle speed. And with that, as you reduce speed, you typically see a decline in the collisions or speed-related collisions. And also, as mentioned before, potentially reducing the cut-through traffic in a neighborhood. Some of the cons: increased emergency response time, increased noise. You can see quite a bit of information about potential increase in costs. A couple things I'll point out there is that for public vehicles, that's like ER trucks, meaning suspension, alignment cost as they go over those speed humps routinely. Later on down the list, you can see that there's some potential for having these speed humps and signs placed right in front of residential properties. And also the very bottom one I'll touch on a little bit, which is sometimes you're chasing the problem, meaning if you saw speed humps on one street, it just moves it over to another street and you're chasing that problem throughout the neighborhood. So some of the key elements of a speed hump program, and there's a lot of agencies that have these programs, so these are pretty consistent across the board. And some of those include both a staff process and a neighborhood process or a resident process. So we'll talk a little bit about staff process, meaning some minimum criteria, and you can see them listed out there. We want to make sure it meets some minimum criteria, otherwise the volume of requests and the volume of speed humps that would be installed would not be feasible. There's an analysis portion of it. We want to make sure that we are addressing some of the most impactful areas. So we're looking at places that have an 85th percentile speed that's at least 9 miles over the posted speed limit, or there's some documented collisions resulting in from the speed-related primary collision factor. And another big one is to make sure that we coordinate with our emergency response team. So that would be fire and PD. As indicated, typically speed humps can reduce emergency response time. Other parts of the key or other key elements to the program is the neighborhood side or the resident side. So we want to make sure that all the residents that would be impacted by the speed humps, if they were placed, are aware of it. So we would require that if a fully vetted request went through the analysis process, we would ask the neighborhood to get 2/3 of their neighbors to agree for installation of the speed humps. And then the other key component would be a ranking and prioritization in the program. So we would want to have a defined point system of how we prioritize requests that actually get through the process. We would suggest that that prioritization be done on a council district level. And we also suggest that any request would be valid for 3 years. A little bit about funding. So we're talking about just the analysis part. It's about $500 to do an analysis, and that asterisk means that this is in 2022 costs. So about $500 per location to do the study. To install speed humps, if they're warranted, is about $25,000, which includes the markings and the speed humps themselves. Again, we recommend a group of three that has been proven to be researched in reducing in speed. And there's an annualized cost of about $500 to maintain those locations in perpetuity. We also would recommend that we would fund by council district. So if we're using a $50,000 per district suggestion, that can do one or two locations per district, and that would result in about $300,000 in any 1 year of funding. There are some agencies that do have programs that allow for either all or a portion of the cost to be privately funded. Staff is not recommending that for Oxnard. It does and can create some inequity issues. So an overview of what we've done so far: we've worked with the city departments, and that's police, fire, and then internal to public works, which is the streets maintenance team and the environmental resources team, plus the city attorney's office, in reviewing some of the key program elements and some of the pros and cons. We were at Public Works and Transportation Committee to discuss this, and we anticipate, if the committee concurs, that we've moved this forward to council. I did want to touch a little bit about some of the fire department and police department comments that we've gotten. As indicated, speed humps do increase the response time, so basically a delay. As you can read there on the fire department's comments about the amount of time associated with survivability. But they do suggest that speed cushions could be used to help minimize the delays with the larger fire vehicles, but they do not have the same positive benefits on ambulances or smaller response vehicles. The police department has indicated their support anticipating a minimal impact to their response time, but they are supportive of the process. Based on some of the comments there, specifically allowing for their resources to be focused on other areas. That concludes my presentation, and available to answer any questions.